I knew a man. I knew him well. A man who talked to himself. The wisest man I ever knew. A word here, an argument there, a moment here, an age there. But question himself, he did, querying his life, his id, his present self, his older self, his younger self. Because, as he often said, he who controls the question controls the conversation. The conversation of your life. Like I said, the wisest man I ever knew. And so it was that his life was defined, a line of time over and over refined. All to answer the big questions, the trick questions, the hard questions, the questions only time may answer, from birth to death. A stitch here, alteration there, tailor-made, year to year. To me, he whispered three answers he had answered well. At 25, he asked if he had enough to make it past 65. His older self replied, "You work just to stay alive." So, to straighten his spine, ahead he towed the line, and before that time, he made retirement fine. At 40, he asked, double shocked, what to do when trouble knocked. And boy, did it knock. His younger self said, "Are you out of your tree? Are you blind to see? What will be, will be." Luckily, and happily, he'd planned to be free. At 76, with a bag out of tricks, it hit him like a ton of bricks. The game towards its end, the one he couldn't mend, yes, death around the bend. Yet, to his family, he did tend his policy to give without end. That is how my dad lived and loved his life. A legacy passed on to me. That space, that line of time, enjoyed from start to finish. A life well lived.